What up, people? So, headed into the weekend, last weekend, final release, the most recent update, patch 2.25, and it has some changes, quite a few changes actually. A new game mode, some battle changes with the new targeting system option, some character customization, and then of course the character changes for the Nobushi and the Peacekeeper. So you know everybody out here running them. But let's get into it. So we can start with the new game mode so I can get my salt out of the way. It's called Battle of the Eclipse. Basically, both teams battle for control of the forge, and then once the forge is fully powered, they use the Draconite Scythe to defeat the empowered enemy leader. I haven't been able to get a game of it because I haven't jumped on during peak hours, and I play on PS4, and all people know on PS4 is Dominion, of course. You'd be like, what you trying to play, dog? Dominion? Oh, Dominion. Oh, Dominion? Like, that's it. That's all you get, so... Looks fun, can't really speak to it. Next, the targeting system changes. It's a new cycle targeting system. It's an option though, you can turn it on. It's not on by default. By default, it's turned off. You can turn it on. This will let you cycle through all four enemy characters when you're getting jumped. I still don't quite know if I love it or hate it because I got so used to it being the other way. So, jury's still out on that. But, check it out. Go into the settings. Give it a shot. Then the bookmarking system. Boom. They added bookmarks to the customization menu. So, now you can have favorites and find your stuff a little bit easier. That applies to outfits, patterns, symbols, embossings, ornaments, materials, color, all, the whole nine. The developer's words. We really want players to be able to explore the fashion of their characters in For Honor. And we know that the number of items players can own can quickly become overwhelming. The bookmarking feature will allow you to sort out your favorite customization elements to easily find them back later down the road. That sounds like a typo. Or help you thematize your loadouts, for instance. Yeah, that was definitely a typo. Anyway. And then the next, to me, is probably the most important change because I spent a whole lot of time fighting that B. The guard break fix. So now when you locked on to people, guard breaking soldiers or minions, that shouldn't happen no more. That was probably the most frustrating thing. But, yeah, that's supposed to be fixed now. So if you still out here guard breaking minions... Hop on the forums, B. Now we can get into the actual character changes. So, PK people are excited. I personally have not played PK very much. I sucked with her. My PK is like level 3. Like, not rep 3, level 3. Yeah. But these changes sound good. So, the zone attack. It's now enhanced. Now counts as a heavy attack when it gets parried. The first hit causes a medium hit reaction. Second hit now feints 100 milliseconds before the parry window. Second hit can now soft feint into dodge at the feint timing. Second hit can now soft feint into guard break at the feint timing. The second hit is now unblockable if Peacekeeper is locked on and the opponent is suffering from bleed. And the zone attack second hit recovery is now 700 milliseconds instead of 1,000. So, developer comments on that. These changes ensure PK's zone attack remains an effective tool. In addition to the testing ground changes, We've also adjusted the first hit granting a medium hit reaction, ensuring that the Peacekeeper is safe when feinting the second hit, as well as lowering the recovery to ensure she is frame advantaged when landing that second hit. And then the dagger cancel. So the dagger cancel now has 400 milliseconds of hit recovery, which is down from 700 milliseconds. And dagger cancel can now cancel its recovery with a dodge at 333 milliseconds. Why that number, I don't know. But it must make sense. It must have had to have been that number. So basically it's supposed to make it so that she's safer in group fights when she getting jumped. So the heavy attacks, all of them now do 2 more damage than they did before, including the side dodge attacks. And then of course, like I said before, the heavy attacks finishers, they gain unblockable status if PK is locked on to you and you're bleeding. So all of this they feel is gonna help balance so that she can deal more damage and be used more in multiplayer game modes. And her deflect attack is now done with the heavy attack button instead of the light attack button. Now, on to the Nobu. The Nobushi. This is like the update that every Nobushi has been waiting for. It's Nobushis everywhere. Maybe I'm just speaking for PS4, but I feel like everybody is experiencing this. The Nobushi flood. Heavy finishers and heavy attacks from hidden stance, they're undodgeable now. So now, and maybe that'll help too. Maybe Nobushis will throw more heavies, right? And mix it up a little bit and maybe throw less lights. Psych, we know that's not gonna happen. But it just makes her better in 1v1. The zone attack. Second hit can now be soft feinted into a kick, heavy finisher, or dodge. Stamina costs have been adjusted to 20 for the first strike, 20 for the second strike, and 10 for a feint. It was 40 for the first strike, 20 for the second strike, and then nothing for a feint. The sidewinder, that now branches into heavy finishers. It changed to a kick and a retreating viper at 400 milliseconds, down from 500 milliseconds, so faster now, more attacks. Ferroner just wants attacking. Cancels its recoveries into dodge and hidden stance at 400 milliseconds, also down from 500 milliseconds. That sidewinder is going to be something to deal with. The hidden stance, it now costs 12 stamina. That's down from 24. Can no longer apply backwards movement to top light from hidden stance. So that's good. I appreciate that. The kick now hides its indicator for the first 166 milliseconds. So they want you reading it. That was about it for Nobushi. Overall, I think those changes are all good. Don't let my salt coming through dim the good that has happened there. Both of those characters, I think that's going to help and make them a little more competitive and playable. There were some feat changes. The Corruption Blade for Warmonger, the cooldown got increased to 90 seconds. Thank goodness, because I felt like they was just popping a thing off every 2 seconds. And then decreased the active time from 2 to 8 seconds from 15. So that feat was like hands down winning matches for people that they probably should have lost. So I think it's good. I think it fits that character, but yeah, I'm glad they toned it down a little bit. But they should have been toning down you know who. And then they made some adjustments to the maps. I'm not gonna go through all of those. Some bug fixes as well. For Kensei, Lawbringer, Nobushi, Shaolin, Zhang Zhong, Black Prior, a whole lot of bug fixes. Some on the bots as well, some interface changes, more customization fixes, all that stuff. I'll leave a link to the patch notes in the video. You'll find it in the description or in the first comment. But yeah, that's about it for the changes. Thanks for tuning in. If you've had a chance to play already and you like the direction that the game is headed in, feel free to leave a comment below. If you don't like the direction the game is headed in, still hook your boy up with a thumbs up and leave a comment down below. And we'll catch you in the next one.